Hey, what's up, guys? Andy here, and today we're reviewing over Demon Slayer Episode 8, The Smell of Enchanting. Now, this episode was... This episode was so good in so many different ways. The animation was on point. I loved every second of it. But it also furthered the story along in four or five different ways. This was par none, like... At least a 9.5 out of 10 episode, and that's just our first reaction. If I go back and watch it, it'll probably be a 10. But, yeah, we got a lot of stuff to talk about. I'm very sorry this video is very delayed, but, Katarina and Alex's wedding was, yesterday, so I couldn't make any videos. If you know who Alex is, he was White Boy Toast on the channel. Back when we used to do Yu-Gi-Oh! Content, so if you remember him, more power to you. And, me and Bradley were the, what are they called? Groomsmen, so to speak. I was the best man, and he was, like, the only other groomsman, so... you know Bradley, he was really big on the channel with the Yu-Gi-Oh! Stuff, so yeah, that kind of took up most of my day. But, we're doing this one now, because I really, really just wanted to watch this episode. And we'll be doing Fairy Tail tomorrow, late night, and maybe Boruto as well. I'm not sure how that's going to work, though, because the Black Clover review, but we'll figure it out. But for this episode, we've got a lot to talk about, so let's go ahead and jump right on into this. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe if y'all do enjoy the video, and let's go ahead and get in. They say you gotta go home, but you can't stay here. So we start our episode off really kind of nicely with the little bit of recap from last week's ending where he turned him into a demon and Tanjiro was jumping him. We cut straight into the intro and the title card here, The Smell of Enchanting Blood, and we go right back into the action where he just dives on this dude, shoves his scarf in this dude's mouth, and he's like, it's alright, somehow it's gonna be all okay. And that's when we kind of figure out, yeah, he's way too nice. But it's a good quality to have. But this motherfucker right here, they're just setting him up so nicely to be a fucking douchebag. He's like, you mustn't look, daughter. It's dangerous here. Let's leave. And I was 150% right on this. This was a distraction. And to get Tanjiro's identity. We will talk a little bit more about the identity thing in a minute, but this was a straight distraction, and you can tell he was kind of distraught by Tanjiro, but we find out why. The cops show up, and they're trying to pull Tanjiro off, thinking that the guy's just drunk, and that's when we get this aroma of visual fantasy, and all these flowers flood in and kind of block the view of everybody. And she says, you refer to him as a person, even though he's a transformed demon. And we find out that this girl is a demon herself. So that's really cool. But we cut back over here to old Muzan. And he's, you know, his little daughter's like, Daddy, come home soon. And he's like, I will, I promise. I just gotta go talk with the police about what happened. And then I got a business trip in the morning. So you need to go home and get to bed. Just being a normal dad. But he's walking down and this drunk guy comes through and hits him and he's like, I'm sorry, it was my bad, I'm in a hurry. And so the drunk guy's like, what do you mean? And he says this set him off. He goes, oh, you look like you're half dead, you're so pale. He hits this dude one time, blows the concrete up and kills this dude, kills his bigger brother, just lifts him up in the air, and he looks at the girl who's with him, he's like, do I look sickly to you? Do I look pale? Is there a problem in my complexion? And he's like, wrong, 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 and like, he flips out. He has a inferiority complex with his skin, or like, not being human, and he stabs her, and he's like, you know what happens to the body? When, the human body, when I keep pumping my blood into them, they can't handle it and their cells die. And this girl turns into a fucking blob and disintegrates right in front of him. It was insane. Right after he's done with that, though, he snaps his finger and his two henchmen show up and he says, bring me the head of the demon slayer who wears the Hanafuda-like earrings. I butchered that name. I know I did. Someone let me know in the comments down below. But he's talking about Tanjiro, and that's when we get this scene. He's like, those damned earrings, and I guarantee you, this is Tanjiro's father. Look at this dude. He's so badass looking. He's got the same earrings, same hair. Oh my god, they set this up perfectly. But we cut back over to Tanjiro, Nezuko, and this other little boy. And he's taking her or them to the lady we seen earlier's place, but it's got a cloaking spell, so they couldn't find it normally. And, you know, he tells her, you know, Tanjiro says when they meet up, he's like, you treat humans, because she's a doctor, while you're a demon. And he's like, you think demons treat humans while choking back their drool of the smell of blood? That's disgusting. And she's like, calm down. My name is Tamayo, and this is... Let me get this name right. Let me find it. My notes are scattered, sorry. Yushiro. And that's when they're talking, and we find out that they can live off blood transfusions without eating human flesh, and that she herself actually turned Yushiro into a demon, which we thought only he could do, but... You know, the million-dollar question here is how, and she said, I don't know, but it took me 200 years to kind of do it. It's been kind of a failure a lot, but then he asked the million-dollar question, is there a way? And we cut over to the two demons he sent out, and this dude can apparently, like, sense people's trails using his eye hands? I didn't really get that too much, but it looked badass. We cut over here, though, to the ending panel. Not the ending, I shouldn't say, because it's coming to the end, but we get to see these two full on close up, and they're like, how should we kill them? You know, they're just a typical crazy demon. And we go back here, and I love Nezuko throughout this whole episode. She's so cute in this. But you know, he's like, there's a way, she tells him there's a way to turn a demon back, but it's gonna take a little bit. It's a possibility. She says, I need two favors. One, I need permission to study your sister's blood, because, you know, Nezuko is special. She's went this long without eating human flesh. And two, I need you to retrieve blood samples for me. So, where that goes, I'm not sure, but this did set up that there is hope for the series for him to actually accomplish his goal besides Muzan. So we cut back over here to them talking, and, you know, she asked him, are you still willing to take my request, even though I'm gonna need blood samples from demons who are very close to Muzan, like, on his level of fighting. Enter two demons, close to Muzan, of his level of fighting. And he's like, did you decide how to kill them? And she's just throwing these balls everywhere and fucks his house completely up, and that's where the episode leaves off. So, I'm really, really excited to see where this goes next week. Unfortunately, I feel like this is going to be a short anime. I hope it gets 24 episodes at least. But, yeah, that's my take on it. I hope y'all did enjoy, and I'm really, really tired, so I'm going to head to bed, and I'll catch y'all next time. Peace out. Take a moment right here, feeling like it's out gear, driving towards the sun, with a rose and a gun, feel the wind in my